This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 20 races to bring you, 17 of them graded. All but one are six figures. The other one is seven. We're going to start off down at Churchill Downs. There's September meet coming to a wrap-up. Saturday evening, we had the first edition of the Homecoming Classic, Fort Larned, 3-10.
The winners of 36 races in the gate. And they're off in the Homecoming Classic. Towards the inside, Prayer for Relief was away alertly, but immediately Fort Larned now engages, and Fort Larned goes on for Brian Hernandez. To the inside rail, Prayer for Relief, and on the outside, Worldly. A break then of 2.5 lengths back to Windswept. A further couple of lengths to Agent Dinozo. And at the back of the field as they go around that first turn is the late-running Pool Play. They have 7/8 of a mile to go in the inaugural running of the Homecoming Classic, and it is Fort Larned out in front now by 2.5 lengths through the quarter of 23-2. Fort Larned takes them down the Churchill Downs backstretch. The lead is 2 lengths over Prayer for Relief racing in second. Worldly, a length away in third. 6 lengths back to Windswept. 2.5, Agent Dinozo. 4 more back to Pool Play. He's racing fully 12 off Fort Larned through the half of 47 seconds flat. And Fort Larned now is extending the lead. It's out to 5 lengths as they leave the back stretch behind them. Worldly has now taken a distant second. In third is Prayer for Relief. There's a break of 6 lengths back to Windswept and Agent Dinozo. And tailed off is Pool Play as they race now on the turn back towards home in the Homecoming Classic. It is Fort Larned who is out in front. Worldly is giving game chase. He's cut the margin down to 3 lengths now in second, but with 3/16 to go, Fort Larned is still out in front, but now being ridden along by Brian Hernandez, but he's still clear by 4. Worldly in second. Windswept is the one now who begins to fly down the outside, but it is Fort Larned who is out in front. The lead is still 2.5 lengths. Windswept is closing, but Fort Larned is the Homecoming King. Fort Larned goes to the defense of his crown at Santa Anita, a winner of the Homecoming Classic in the hands of Brian Hernandez.
And Fort Larned, little bumping of the gate early in the race, though, sprints clear to the front under Brian Hernandez and just makes every pole a winning one, returning $2.60 for Ian Wilkes and Janice Whittam. Windswept finished second, and the longest shot on the board, Worldly, at nearly 30-1, finishes third in the inaugural running of the Homecoming Classic. Also on Saturday evening at Churchill Downs, used to be a spring race, springtime race, but it's 3-year-olds going a mile now in the Jefferson Cup. General Election, the 2-1 favorite.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Jefferson Cup. Towards the inside, Redwood Kitten flashes early speed, and so too Tate's Landing, and between them, Bellino, and these three blazing the trail early. Redwood Kitten to the inside hedge. Bellino in the orange, and out wide is Tate's Landing. These three taking no prisoners early. A break of 3 lengths back to Miscelli through the quarter of 22-4. There's then a break opening up of a further 3 lengths to Gentleman's Kitten. General Election at the back of the field with one more cat as they head down the back straight in the 37th running of the Jefferson Cup. And the leader out wide is Tate's Landing, taken very wide here by Robbie Alvarado. Towards the hedge is Bellino, and these are the first two. In third is Redwood Kitten. Now beginning to close up in fourth is Miscelli. In fifth, towards the inside, Gentleman's Kittners are going to the turn. General Election has six lengths to find on the leader. And out the back of the field is One More Cat. They went 46-2 for the half. They're beginning to bunch up now. And Tate's Landing has the lead. But the pursuers are now being headed by Redwood Kitten around the outside, Miceli. And also there, Gentleman's Kitten with the red blinkers. The white colours of General Election now begins to loom as well. Inside the final furlong and a half, down the outside, Redwood Kitten now strikes for home. Towards the inside hedge is Gentleman's Kitten. Here comes General Election eating up the ground. 100 yards to go. General Election goes alongside Redwood Kitten. General Election wins the Jefferson Cup. It's set up perfectly for General Election, who wins for Joe Rocco Jr. to the inside, Redwood Kitten in second.
Joe Rocco Jr., not the last time we'll see him on this week's program, scores the neck victory as the popular $6.20 choice for Kelly Gorder. Redwood Kitten finishes second as a second choice. Third choice in the wagering, Gentleman's Kitten finishes third in the 37th running of the Jefferson Cup. Now we're going to go to Oklahoma, ladies and gentlemen, the 25th anniversary of Remington Park. And up first on Sunday afternoon, we're going to have the Remington Oaks, the 4-5 favorite Marathon Lady.
They're off, and the Remington Park Oaks, all the way in good order. Sister Ginger from the outside, trying to get up and save some ground. They cross the line first time. Gold Medal Dancer in between runners, a nose on the front. At the rail now going on, Montana Native. Montana Native uses the rail to take the lead into the first turn. Marathon Lady, Gold Medal Dancer outside of her. At the rail fourth, Satin Gold wide through the first turn now is Sister Ginger. After that, it's Legal Mind and Touch Magic, the trailer, seven off the lead. As they go to the backstretch, by a long neck, it's Marathon Native, Montana Native over Gold Medal Dancer to the backstretch. Marathon Lady is third, three lengths off the pace. Outside, Sister Ginger stays clear in a good spot, fourth. Legal Mind and Satin Gold moving together. The trailer still Touch Magic, 23-2/5 for the opening quarter, midway up the backstretch, and the company up front getting a little tighter. As Montana Native being pressed all the way now by Gold Medal Dancer, a half mile to go. The opening half went in 46-4/5. Outside, Sister Ginger going wide to the second turn as well. A length back in third into that turn, there is Marathon Lady. Three furlongs left in the Oaks, and still up front, Montana Native nose to nose with Gold Medal Dancer. Now Marathon Lady stays wide in third within a half length of the front runner. Sister Ginger appears to have had enough with a quarter mile to go. Six furlongs in 1 minute, 11 and change. And up front, Montana Native trying to show the way despite pressure all the way from Gold Medal Dancer. Still on the front by almost a full length now. Shaking the reins one more time, Luis Quinones and Gold Medal Dancer trying to stay alongside Montana Native. These two, five lengths clear now of Marathon Lady inside the 16th. Race on, late in the Oaks. Outside, Gold Medal Dancer inside Montana Native. Bobby noses to the line. Photo finish in the Oaks. Photo finish for win. Montana Native inside, Gold Medal Dancer outside.
And Montana Native, last seen at Saratoga, now seen in the winner's circle by a nose victory under Terry Thompson as the second choice in the wagering. For Ken McPeak, Montana Native from an inside post position makes the front and Jess holds on, returning $7. Gold Medal Dancer finishes second. Sister Ginger finishes third, with the odds-on favorite Marathon Lady finishing fourth. And the co-feature on Sunday afternoon, the 25th running of the Remington Park Derby, departing the 3-10 favorite.
Well, the big favorite departing outside, all in. They're off in the 25th Oklahoma Derby. Carve away sharply. Also right there, Broadway Empire early on cameo appearance outside third. Between runners, Holiday Mischief is fourth. Departing is wide to this point. Starting to move up a bit. There goes the gray, He Has Bling, as they pass the line first time. The leader, Broadway Empire, by a half length over He Has Bling and cameo appearance going to the turn. Carve is at the rail fourth, just a head better than Brave Man. Hung wide a bit, three wide. That's departing outside sixth. Two clear of Holiday Mischief. The trailer is Texas Bling. The opening quarter in 23-1/5, and Broadway Empire will take them to the backstretch. A leader by three lengths with six furlongs to go. He Has Bling nose to nose with cameo appearance. Carve in a good spot, fourth at the rail with clear sailing. Departing, staying clear outside fifth, ahead better than Brave Man. A length and a half back to Holiday Mischief. Now Texas Bling begins to open stride a little bit and try to join the rest of the field. The half mile at 46 and 3/5, a fair pace set by Broadway Empire with a half mile to go now in the Oklahoma Derby. Carve is now second, just inside of Cameo Appearance. Departing has begun the move outside. It's Departing now fourth, only three back as they approach the far turn. Moving to the far outside, Brave Man, Holiday Mischief, Texas Bling has an opening at the rail and begins to motor on. Three furlongs left, still Broadway Empire on top. Cameo Appearance is second, Departing wide in third. Carve backs up to fourth. A quarter mile to go. Broadway Empire will take them to the front stretch as well after six furlongs and a minute 11 and change. Broadway Empire is on top and is opened up by four in the Oklahoma Derby. Broadway Empire all the way on the front. Cameo Appearance and Departing after that, battling for second, a furlong to go. Broadway Empire trying to pull the upset here is out by five. The Canadian Derby winner out by six. Carve tries to pick things up. It's Broadway Empire stealing the show in the Oklahoma Derby. Broadway Empire pulls the upset to win it by four. Broadway Empire, a four-length winner over Cameo Appearance. Photos after that.
But Broadway Empire goes to the front, draws off comfortable fractions, and then sets down in the lane to win by four under Rico Walcott. The upset victory for Broadway Empire, he returns $8.80. Cameo Appearance finishes second. Carr finished third. Departing at 3-10 finishes fourth. Ladies and gentlemen, the show prices, $30, $43.60, and $76.40 for Carve, which was about $30 more than Carve would have paid to win the Oklahoma Derby. But Broadway Empire scores the upset victory in Sunday's Oklahoma Derby. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll head out to Santa Anita.
Hi, this is Andy Serling inviting you to join me at the Clubhouse Racebook. I'll be handicapping the day's Naira card live and managing a $2,500 bankroll. To be part of my bankroll team, sign up at the Clubhouse or online at CapitalOTB.com. See you then, and let's win together.
Hi, race fans. I'm Seth Merrow with some great news. Now you can get live streaming of all our tracks. Just log on to CapitalOTB.com, click on the live streaming link, and choose from more than 35 tracks from around the world. Plus, you can now get race replays any day, any track. And don't forget to check out our new virtual tote board. In horse racing, information is key, and no one brings you the crucial information you need like CapitalOTB.com. Live streaming, race replays, and our new virtual tote board, CapitalOTB.com. Check it out now.
I've been coming here for well over 30 years to the OTB, and I think this is an outstanding facility. Probably comparable to something you'd see in Vegas. They have the big screens there, and then they have the auxiliary screens for, you know, watching all the tracks. And the primary tracks of the day, they'll switch to the big screens, which is ideal for most of us race guys. We like to see the big races on the big screen. Well done.
Friday afternoon was opening day at Santa Anita's fall meet. The Eddie D Stakes, 6.5 furlongs down the hill. On Bridal's Note, the 5-2 chalk.
Goes in, all set now for the Eddie D. And away they go. All appear to come out well. On the far side, Al Mirage King is away quickly, but they're all lining up here. Chip Zarin is showing early speed. There's Snow Day, and now Rossengold. Rossengold will get the lead. Just in behind that comes Rock Me Baby in the black cap along the inside. Ed Two Walkers making headway. Then it's Unbridled Note, six off them. Couldn't be going any quicker. Coracatado's behind that. Just in behind them comes Boat Trip, and then there's a big gap of five back to Majestic City, and Huntsville is last. Strung out over a lot of ground now as they come down the hill. Out on the lead is Rossengold, a close-up second. Snow Day traveling well, going to take on the leader. Chips All In is right there as well. On the far side, El Mirage King. Behind that comes Sirocco Strike. Get Two Walkers in there. Rock Me Baby, only three lengths off them. Coracatado's on the outside. Unbridled Note, they're all bunched together as they come for home. Chips All In, Snow Day in the white cap on the inside. Now here comes Coracatado on the outside. Coracatado closing ground. Unbridled Note coming with a late run as well. And Rock Me Baby still wide open. Chips All In. Chips All In on the outside. Boat Trip. Chips All In. Chips All In. Boat Trip like a rocket leg. Gets close in the end. Then Unbridled Note. Coracatado right there fourth.
Chips All In. Just second choice in the wagering. Scores the neck victory. Nose victory, excuse me, coming down the hill. under Julien Lepereux, returning $7.80 for Jeff Mullins. Boat Trip, well back early, just gets nipped by not making it to the line ahead of Chips All and did the best they could. 10th at the 8th pole, ladies and gentlemen, and it was quite crowded on the turf at Santa Anita. Unbridled's Note finishes 3rd as the favorite in Friday's Eddie D Stakes. Big afternoon on Saturday. Up first, 2-year-old fillies in the Chandelier Stakes. Fascinating, 6-5.
Goes in. And away they go to a good beginning. She's a tiger from the outside gate as quick, but so is Awesome Baby, and Awesome Baby now sprinting away. Couldn't be going any quicker out there. Harlington's Rose, the long shot, goes with her. Now She's a Tiger's tucked in right behind the leaders, and Secret Compass down on the inside. Those four going very fast early. Then we come back to Antiquity, Fascinating down at the rail as 5 lengths off the leaders, and Bell of the Fleet sit at the back of the pack. They hit past the three-quarter pole, and Harlington's Rose out in front of half a length. Slowed it down a tad now, though. On the far side, we have She's a Tiger racing in just behind the leaders. Between those two comes Awesome Baby. Down on the rail is Secret Compass. They've been followed by Antiquity. And then we come back to Bell of the Fleet and Fascinating at the rails. 6 lengths would cover the lot. They have a half mile to go, and She's a Tiger now kicks on for the lead, and She's a Tiger kicks for home early. She's a Tiger now opening up on them into the far turn. Awesome Baby is in the second spot. Behind that comes Secret Compass in third. Then we come back to Fascinating and Antiquity. They got about 10 to make up. They are coming to the quarter pole. No turning back for She's a Tiger now in front by 2. But here comes Secret Compass cutting into that stride. Lead now, and then it's another 7 back to Fascinating. Fascinating's getting involved from third. At the top of the lane, She's a Tiger's holding on. Secret Compass, Fascinating still chasing after them from third. She's a Tiger hangs on to the lead. Secret Compass, Fascinating plugging away from third. She's a Tiger. Secret Compass, nose and nose, Fascinating on the outside. Secret Compass, Secret Compass got up to win it ahead. She's a Tiger second. Fascinating finished a close third.
Secret Compass for Bob Baffert as the second longest shot on the board scores the upset victory with Rosie the Pravnik in the saddle. Secret Compass returns $23.40. She's a Tiger, second choice in the wagering coming out of the Del Mar Debutante score, finishes second. And Fascinating, runner-up in the Del Mar Debutante, the 6-5 favorite, finishes third, 19 lengths in front of the fourth-place horse in this year's Chandelier. Next up at Santa Anita, what we used to call the Yellow Ribbon, now called the Rodeo Drive. Fillies and mares, 1.25, grade 1 on the turf. Marketing mix, 6-5.
Goes in, gates closed, all set. And away they go, and Vionette got a flyer out of there. Hopped a length and a half in front the first jump. Vionette going on to set the early pace. Marketing mix going to sit right there in second. On the far side, we have Starstruck now moving up third. In behind that is Tiz Flirtatious, now rider dropping her back into mid-pack. Along the inside comes Lady of Shamrock. She's been followed then by Topic, and up alongside of Topic is My Gigi. Through the stretch first time round, and Vionette goes on to lead them now by 2.5. Marketing Mix is tracking from the second spot, and Starstruck is in third. Then it's Tiz Flirtatious, a very comfortable fourth, taking a nice hold, just 4.5 off the leader. Lady of Shamrock back third last, been followed then by Topic, and My Gigi is the early trailer. 8 lengths would cover them all. They head to the three-quarter pole, and Vionette now sneaking away up front without using up any excess energy, and Vionette now goes clear to lead it by 3.5. Marketing Mix is racing along in the second spot. Starstruck is in third. Tiz Flirtatious still travels comfortably in the fourth spot, gives them 5 lengths start. They're closing in on that leader now. Then it's Lady of Shamrock, Topic, and My Gigi. They have a half mile to go, and it's still Vionette in front, but only by a length and a half now. Marketing Lex is right there, second. Starstruck in third. Tis Flirtatious, four and a half off the leaders. Behind that, Lady of Shamrock, My Gigi, sent along on the inside, and Topic is last. They are coming to the top of the lane, and it's still Vionette kicking for home now, tries to shake loose again. Vionette by length and three quarter. Marketing Mix comes after her. Starstruck on the outside, and now Tis Flirtatious pulled to the grandstand side, and Tis Flirtatious let loose, coming home gamely in the center, but Vionette's tough on the lead. Vionette, Tis Flirtatious catching on the outside between the Marketing Mix. Three of them run for the wire together. Tis Flirtatious, grandstand side. Tis Flirtatious, Marketing Mix, and a thriller. Tis Flirtatious won it. Marketing Mix, Vionette, a very come good third. Behind that was Starstruck.
Tis Flirtatious for Marty Jones scores the victory under Julian Leperoux, a second choice in the wagering. She returns $5.40. Marketing Mix the favorite with Gary Stevens in the saddle finishes second. And the longest shot on the board, V&A, finishes third at nearly 30-1 in the Rodeo Drive. They call it Rodeo Drive, but we get the point. Up next, two-year-olds in what used to be the Norfolk Stakes, now the Front Runner Stakes, Grade 1, Dance with Fate, 2-1.
Goes in, gates closed. And away they go. Tamarando is off a little awkwardly. He's going to be last early. Can the Man is very fast, and Can the Man gets the early lead. Here's Test Ride, the grey, sprinting up on the outside. Ontology's right there at the rail. Dance with Fate getting a good spot right behind the leaders in the pink colours. Better Bet on the outside. Oh, Ontology didn't corner too wide here, and that put Even Echo in tight quarters. Even Echo drifted out a bit. Better Bet is racing on the outside of that. Bondholder down at the rail is now 8 lengths off the leaders. Then we come back to Flat Gone. Tamarando is taken back second last, and Round Up the Loot is at the back. Down the backstretch they go, and it's Test Ride now just in front. Been taken on now by Can the Man. Can the Man, Test Ride, go to the half mile together. Dance with Fate in a good spot, third, right behind the leaders. Then it's Ontology. Better Bet is back in the fifth spot. They've been followed by Even Echo, now having to be ridden along. Bondholder making headway at the rail in the white cap. In behind that comes Flat Gone. Then comes Tamarando and Round Up the Loot. They 10 off the lead. They have 3/8 of a mile to go, and Can the Man takes the lead. Can the Man goes for home. Taken on now by Dance with Fate. Can the Man, Dance with Fate, the two coming to the quarter pole to battle it out. Ontology's next. Bondholder tries to make headway. They're at the top of the lane. Can the Man, but Dance with Fate being confidently ridden. These two turn for home, nose and nose. Bondholder's trying to come and make take them on past the eighth pole now. Homeward bound, and it's Dance with Fate, the leader. Dance with Fate, Bondholder's closing steady ground on the outside though. And Bondholder's catching Dance with Fate. Bondholder's got him. Bondholder to win, going away. Bondholder beat Dance with Fate. Tamarando came from last to get third. Close for fourth, Can the Man, and Flat Gone.
Bondholder for Doug O'Neill, Redham Racing, and Mario Gutierrez. They score the upset victory, returning a few shekels more than the chandelier, $23.80. Dance with Fate returns, finishes second as a 2-1 favorite. Tamarando, the recent winner of the Del Mar Futurity, finishes third in the front runner. If you see the teletimer, the girls, the two-year-old fillies, went faster in the chandelier than the two-year-old colts went in the front runner. Also at Sanity on Saturday afternoon, we have three-year-olds and up, fillies and mares, on the dirt, in the Zenyatta, Beholder, 8-5.
And away they go. Beholder broke beautifully, and Beholder goes straight to the lead. Include Me Out gets up second. Joyful Victory's taken back into third, going to be carried a little wide into the turn. Via Villaggio, meanwhile, is right there at the rail. They really tightly packed. More Chocolate has floated four wide into the turn. Then comes Flashy American and Authenticity last, but no more than 5 lengths covers them all. They head to the three-quarter pole, and Beholder, nice and relaxed out here. Gary Stevens just got on a long rein, lopes them along 3/4 of a length to Include Me Out. Joyful Victory's the grey on the far side. More Chocolate has to go wide as well. Authenticity now moving into contention down at the rail, and Authenticity comes through fourth, only two lengths off the leaders. Flashy American next, and the long shot Via Villaggio's last. They run past a half-mile pole, and still Beholder not being bothered on the lead yet. On the far side is Joyful Victory. Between them, Include Me Out. Authenticity threatening to run a big one at the rail now, just needs somewhere to run. Then Flashy American, More Chocolate, and Via Villaggio. They come into the 5/16ths, and Beholder has not been asked to run yet. Include Me Out, putting the pressure on now. On the outside, Joyful Victory. Authenticity now looking for somewhere to go. They're at the top of the lane in the Zenyatta, and Beholder now, Gary Stevens, super confident, hasn't moved on her yet. Beholder the leader, Authenticity down the center, Joyful Victor now being hard ridden. They come for home, and Beholder is clear by four lengths now. Authenticity's run a big one, but just a scintillating performance from Beholder. Gary Stevens barely moved on her. Couldn't have been more impressive. Authenticity was second. Joyful Victory finished third.
And there's no way that Beholder can win a three-year-old filly championship, but Richard Mandela has done a fantastic job with this three-year-old filly, the offspring of Henny Hughes. Only the second race since the Kentucky Oaks. Very impressive, going to the front under Gary Stevens as the favorite. She beats the elders. Authenticity shipping in from Saratoga finishes second, and Joyful Victory, second choice in the wagering, finishes third in the Zenyatta. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, more action from Santa Anita, a stop at Finger Lakes, and then on to Belmont Park.
Hi, this is Andy Serling inviting you to join me at the Clubhouse Racebook. I'll be handicapping the day's Naira card live and managing a $2,500 bankroll. To be part of my bankroll team, sign up at the Clubhouse or online at capitalotb.com. See you then, and let's win together.
Face it, some mobile websites are just too much. Too much clutter. Too much to navigate through. Next time, log on to capitalotb.com. There you'll find everything you need. Clear, concise, easy to navigate. Check your account, wager, watch replays, get results. All the information you want with none of the clutter. CapitalOTB.com mobile, try it now.
Listen to what people are saying about the Clubhouse Racebook.
It's really nice. It's really modern, open, bright, and there's definitely a lot more machines where you can make your wagers. And I like the fact that it's open anywhere I look, I can see. Football, if I want to, or any of the tracks. Then I can also see the people that I've seen for many years. You feel comfortable. The staff is great. It makes you feel comfortable. It's a nice place to spend an afternoon on your weekend.
Wrapping up the stakes action on Saturday afternoon with three-year-olds and up, mile and eighth on the dirt, the awesome again stakes, Mucho Macho Man, the 8-5 choice.
And away they go. All came out smartly. Summer Hit wants the early lead, is sent along, and Summer Hit will cross over the leader. Chief Havoc is getting up to race in second. Mucho Macho Man right there in third. Soy Fett alongside of him. Painter, meanwhile, drops down into fifth, being followed by Golden Ticket. Liaison is seven lengths off these leaders. Then there's another gap of four lengths further back to Take Control, who's dropped back third last. I know, second last, and Geronimo's a good 14 off the leader. They head to the three-quarter pole, and Summer Hit went fast early, but he slowed them right down. Now Summer Hit in front by a length. Chief Havoc quite content to sit there in second. Soy Fett is in third. Mucho Macho Man on the far side is four lengths off the leaders. Painter's on the inside of him. Then comes Golden Ticket and Liaison. They give them six-length start. Behind that comes Take Control and You Know I Know, and Geronimo, long, long way back today. Geronimo's last about seven. They run past a half-mile pole now, and on the far side, Chief Havoc now turns the pressure on, and Chief Havoc now kicking for home. Summer Hit tries to go with him. Soy Fett is right there. Mucho Macho Man, 2-4 wide, but Mucho Macho Man goes to tackle the leaders. Painter is four lengths off the leaders. Inside of that, Golden Ticket and Liaison. They are coming to the top of the lane. Chief Havoc between them. Mucho Macho Man on the outside. Summer Hit tries to hang tough, but loses ground. Now Golden Ticket Naked comes to take them on. Soyfet in behind Dad and Painter on the grandstand side. Homeward bound and Mucho Macho Man now kicks away from them. Mucho Macho Man starting to open up on them as they come for home. And a scintillating performance from Mucho Macho Man and Gary Stevens as they take the Grade One Awesome again in effortless fashion. Second will be Painter, then Soyfet, and Golden Ticket finish fourth.
And Mucho Macho Man from a tough outside post position under Gary Stevens scores the 4-plus length victory very, very impressively, returning $5.20. Painter, second choice in the wagering, rebounds slightly from his poor effort at Saratoga to finish second. Soyfet finishes third at better than 20-1 in the Awesome again. Sunday afternoon, one stakes race to bring you a mile and a quarter for three-year-olds and up on the turf. This is the John Henry Turf Championship. And recently, last place runner in the Arlington Million, Indy Point, once again a favorite.
Slim Shady goes back in. Gates closed. They're all set. Field sent on their way. They all appear to come out smoothly. Tail of a champion, Slim Shady on the far side and Teeks North. But Teeks North wants the lead and shoots through on the inside to take over. Right behind them comes Indy Point settling on the inside. Didn't cross the sand all that well. Old Time Hockey's in there too. Just in behind those two now comes Code of Conduct in the black cap in the center. Down at the rail we have Holding Glory alongside of Irish Surf. Then we come back to Vagabond Shoes, who's taken back towards the rear. Lucayan is dropping in a good 12 lengths off these leaders now. Inside of that is Kettle Corn and the long shot off Freitando is last. They head to the three-quarter pole, and now it's Slim Shady. Got an easy lead out. He has it all his own way. Slim Shady leads them by just over a length. Teeks North is tracking from second. They're not in any hurry at all. Tail of a champion, third. Alongside of that comes Old Time Hockey in the gold cap. They've been followed by Code of Conduct, and now here's Indy Point, traveling very comfortably in six, just loping along, four and a half off the leaders. Then it's Irish Sea Holding Glory. Behind that comes Vagabond Shoes. Kettle Corn is now 10 lengths off these leaders, then Lucayan and Afraitando. They head past the half-mile pole, and it is still Slim Shady showing the way. On second place comes Teeks North. Just behind that, Tail of a Champion, Old Time Hockey. At the rail, Holding Glory is sent along early. Indy Point is right there. Indy Point in fifth now, and Indy Point going to make his run on the outside. He's got the gold cap. In behind that comes Vagabond Shoes. Kettle Corn is running on from behind, and then Lucayan. They come to the top of the lane, and Indy Point is now hooked to the grandstand side. Slim Shady holding on down at the rail. Teeks North running a big one between them. Vagabond Shoes in with a shot and Old Time Hockey, but it's Indian Point. Indian Point strikes the front end, full flight for the wire. Vagabond Shoes chases, but Indy Point gives another big win for Gary Stevens. They've won the John Henry Turf. Big run from Vagabond Shoes second. Lucayan came flying late to get third.
And oh my, what another terrific job by Gary Stevens and Richard Mandela. Indy Point, a convincing winner of Sunday's John Henry Turf Championship. The favorite returns $6 even. Vagabond Shoes finishes second, with Loikian finishing third in the John Henry. Saturday afternoon at Finger Lakes, the extremely lucrative New York Breeders' Futurity, over $230,000 on the line. Wired Brian, 7-10.
Sidearm is in, ready for a start. And there they go in the 51st running of the New York Breeders' Futurity. And there goes Wired Brian to get the early lead. Fox Rocks is right there in second. Ogremeister comes away running in the third spot. Sidearm comes away running in fourth. He's five lengths off the lead. Blue Collar Cat to his inside. It's nearly three and a half back to Free Mugatoo, who is the early trailer. Wired Brian has the lead, a swift opening quarter of 22 seconds. Wired Brian and Jamie Rodriguez better than a length. Fox Rocks continues to pursue the pace to the 3/8. Ogremeister just under four lengths off the lead. It's nearly six to Sidearm with Blue Collar Cat. And Free Mugatoo is finding his stride. He is making up ground three wide, but he has lots of work to do. Wired Brian's the one to beat, turning for home. Wired Brian at the top of the lane in the New York Breeders' Futurity, a widening four. In second is Fox Rocks. Ogre Meister has been third throughout. Free Mugatu is into the fourth spot, but he's a long ways from the front, and the front belongs to Wired Brian. He is a flying Brian this afternoon. Wired Brian dominating this group in the New York Breeders' Futurity. He's a powerful gate-to-wire winner. Ogre Meister is second, and Fox Rocks and Free Mugatu.
And Michael Dilger continues his good work with Wired Brian as they go out to Finger Lakes and score a convincing seven-length victory under Jamie Rodriguez, returning $3.40. Ogre Meister checks in second with Fox Rocks, finishing third in the 51st running of the New York Breeders' Futurity. Turning our attention to the great afternoon of racing Saturday afternoon at Belmont Park. Up first, fifth race on the card, the Beldame Invitational, three-year-olds and up, fillies and mares at 1-5, Royal Delta.
And they're off. Little stumble there for Royal Delta coming out of the starting gate, but she's quickly making strides and has gone to the lead from the inside. Roman Invader with some early speed and centering as well on the far outside. So Royal Delta's got some company early on here. Royal Delta in front narrowly. Roman Invader coming through on her inside now to take the lead. Roman Invader has taken over. Royal Delta runs in second, followed by centering third. Princess of Silmar is now running along in fourth. She settles back about 5.5 lengths from the long shot leader, Roman Invader. Farther back, the trailer is And Why Not. First quarter was up in 23 3/5 seconds. So down the back stretch they go, and Royal Delta maneuvers right alongside Roman Invader. Roman Invader narrowly. Royal Delta, Mike Smith sitting chilly in the saddle. And then it's centering on the outside. Princess of Silmar is only three lengths from the lead with 5 furlongs remaining. They picked up the tempo here. The half was 46 3/5 seconds, so they move into the far turn. Roman Invader out there on a 30-5-1 prayer. And here comes Royal Delta. The champion's making her move now, and tracking her is the three-year-old filly, Princess of Silmar. She is following Royal Delta around the course as they make their way toward the top of the stretch. Three quarters up in 1:10-2. Royal Delta, the leader, Princess of Silmar, targeting her. And here comes Princess of Silmar, who sidles up alongside Royal Delta. So the stage is set at the top of the stretch here at Belmont Park. Royal Delta down inside, narrowly on the outside, Princess of Silmar. There's absolutely nothing between them with 1 furlong to go. And it is Princess of Silmar. Princess of Silmar is in front. Royal Delta will be defeated, and it is Princess of Silmar. It took a champion to defeat a champion today in the Beldame. Princess of Silmar, the winner, by a length and a half. Royal Delta finishing second. Centering was third. The final time was 1:47-4.
But now, without any question, sure to be named, hopefully, the unanimous three-year-old filly champion, the first... bred horse for Ed Stanko of Linton High School. Princess of Silmar continues her dynamic role, scoring the upset victory as second choice in the wagering under Javier Castellano. Princess of Silmar returns $6.20. Royal Delta finishes second at 1-5 with centering third, well back in the Beldame. Continuing on the dirt at Belmont Park, we're going to go the 1 mile Kelso Handicap Gradar off of the March 30th layoff, 4-5.
And the rough. Super speedy. Gradar's got some speed today. Down on the inside, here comes Gradar, sent to the front. Gradar to be the leader. Super Speedy now runs along in second. Brujo de Oyeros on the outside third. Hymnbook is fourth. Easter Gift and Jackson Bend at the back of the pack. Praetoreo at the front of the pack is Gradar. So the favorite gets the opening quarter here in 23 2/5 seconds. Leads Super Speedy by a length. Easter Gift now third on the inside with 5 furlongs remaining. Hymnbook being nudged along.
Rodeo Yaris is in the clear on the outside. Prey Tereo and Jackson Bend, the trailer, but only five lengths from the lead. And Jackson Bend starting to get underway here. And Gradar halfway home here in 47 seconds flat, with Super Speedy still running on in second. Brujo de Oyeros on the outside, third. Easter Gift, Jackson Bend, Hymnbook, Prey Tereo at the back. Less than three furlongs to go. Gradar still grinding it out on the lead. Gradar will come to the top of the stretch. Still out there in front by length over Super Speedy, running in second. Brujo de Oyeros is mounting a bid. A bold bid on the outside from third now. And then it's Easterbook and Hymnbook into the final furlong now. Brujo de Oyeros on the outside. Gradar digging down and digging down. Gamely. Super Speedy's fighting on, but he's in a little bit tight there. Hymnbook coming on the far outside. Final try. Gradar 50 yards from home. Gradar took him all the way. Gradar won at three quarters of a length. Brujo de Oyeros second. Hymnbook third. Close fourth. Super Speedy or Easter Gift.
Masterful job by Edgar Prado, ladies and gentlemen. Coming off of the New Orleans handicap, Gradar, the layoff, goes to the front, makes every call, looked to be tiring in the lane, but Edgar Prado gets Gradar home for Todd Pletcher. They return $3.80. Brujo, a very, very nice effort as the second longest shot on the board, finishes second. And for a brief moment, I thought Hymnbook, was making a nice run, but he flattened out in the Kelso. Sprinters up next, six furlongs in the Grade 1 Vosburgh. Justin Phillip, the recent winner of the Grade 1 Vanderbilt, 5-2.
And they're off. Justin Phillip breaks on top. There goes Private Zone. And Strapping Groom up the backstretch. Private Zone out for that lead. Strapping Groom right with him on his inside. The Lumber Guys come out running in third. Justin Phillip is now fourth, followed by Bahamian Squall, fifth, about five lengths from the lead. It's another two to Candyman E. Well behind the good three-year-old, 40 Tails, around the far turn. And it is Private Zone, as is his wont, has gone to the front. A 22-3 opening quarter mile. Last year's Vosburgh winner, the Lumber Guy, looms second now. Strapping Groom third toward the inside. Justin Phillip has been guided to clear sailing on the outside. That one is closely followed here by Bahamian Squall. Another three to Candy Manny and another three to 40 Tails. So it's Private Zone in front as they turn for home. A half mile in 44-4. Private Zone coming to the eighth pole with the lead, but here comes Justin Phillip to the attack with an eighth of a mile to go. Private Zone digs down deeply, but Justin Phillip keeps on coming at him. Nip and tuck. Those two full throttle under the line. Private Zone coming back. Private Zone comes back. A courageous victor here. Justin Phillip lost the lead, strides from the wire. Final time, 108 flat.
Doug O'Neill ships in with Martin Pedroza with Private Zone. They go to the front. They just hold off Justin Phillip by a neck as the second choice in the wagering to win the Vosburgh, returning $9.20. Justin Phillip finishes second, with Strapping Groom finishing third. Take a quick break. When we come back, more stakes action from Belmont.
Hi, this is Andy Serling inviting you to join me at the Clubhouse Racebook. I'll be handicapping the day's Naira card live and managing a $2,500 bankroll. To be part of my bankroll team, sign up at the Clubhouse or online at CapitalOTB.com. See you then, and let's win together.
Face it, some mobile websites are just too much. Too much clutter. Too much to navigate through. Next time, log on to CapitalOTB.com. There you'll find everything you need. Clear, concise, easy to navigate. Check your account, wager, watch replays, get results. All the information you want with none of the clutter. CapitalOTB.com mobile, try it now.
Hey race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Continue with the stakes action from Belmont Park, Phillies and Mares, mile and a quarter on the turf. This is the Flower Bowl Invitational. The Alan Goldberg entry, 3-5.
And they're off. And laughing immediately has gone to the front. Somali Lemonade has come out running in second, followed by Valiant Girl. Over at the inside, Mystical Star gets a ground-saving position as they make their way for the clubhouse turn. White Rose will be hung up wide as they move into that turn. And then farther back, Tannery sits back in sixth as her stablemate leads the way. Right next to Tannery is Kyushi, and the trailer here is Kissable in the opening quarter mile. First quarter was up in a pokey 25 3/5 seconds. So it is laughing on an uncontested and easy lead. Somali Lemonade sits back second. White Rose also unhurried while third. And then it's Mystical Star right on the hedge and hard held as they're really slowing down this pace here. Laughable on top. Jose Lascano threw out the anchor to try to slow it down. The opening quarter went in 25 3/5 seconds, and they stroll through a pedestrian half mile of 51-2. So the field continues down the backstretch run. It's still laughing on top. Somali Lemonade is second, followed by White Rose, who's in the clear on the outside third. Mystical Star continues fourth down the inside. Valiant Girl on hold while fifth. Kyushi on the outside is sixth. Tannery is buried down toward the inside with a half mile to go here, about six lengths from her front-running stablemate, and then a break of another three back to the trailer Kissable as they round the far turn. Three quarters up, 16 flat. Laughing still on top. Somali Lemonade turning up that pressure now as the cadence quickens with three furlongs remaining. Laughing narrowly. Somali Lemonade is right alongside. White Rose on the outside. Mystical Star just in behind the lead. Kyushi takes to the far outside, and Kyushi's coming on. And then Valiant Girls in behind horses. And Tannery. Tannery comes off cover now. They're coming into the final furlong. Laughing still there. Laughing is still in front. Here comes her stablemate. Tannery with a flying finish on the outside. And Mystical Star has had a perfect trip so far. They're coming down to the finish. Laughing in front. Mystical Star and Tannery on the outside, and at the wire, the entries 1-2. Laughing took them all the way on the lead. Tannery got up for second. Mystical Star was third, and Kyushi was fourth.
And folks, the Flower Bowl, been a grade one on the turf since the early 80s, had about three favorites win over 30 years. Well, the favorite finishes first and second, Alan Goldberg's Exacta. Jose Lescano back in the saddle since for the first time since August 25th, scores the victory with Laughing aboard going to the front. Tannery, the other part of the entry under Javier Castellano, comes running late. The entry for Alan Goldberg runs 1-2, returning $3.20. Mystical Star finishes third in the Flower Bowl. Now time for three-year-olds and up on the turf to go 12 furlongs in the Joe Hirsch Turf Classic. Odds on the Big Blue Kitten, Real Solution.
And they're off. Joe's Blazing Aaron, wasting no time. Ken Kreese has got some good speed, too. And over down toward the inside, Natello, forwardly placed. So they make this long quarter-mile run to the first turn. And it is Joe's Blazing Aaron out there doing his job to establish the pace here over King Creaser running along in second. Imagining tugs his way up to be third, just on the outside of Nutella running along in fourth. Little Mike is fifth. He'll be three wide moving into the turn, followed by Twilight Eclipse running along in sixth. Slumber is now seventh. The two stablemates here of the three-ply entry are second to last and last. It is second to last is Real Solution, and the very last of them all is Big Blue Kitten. So they make their way around the first turn. As Joe's Blazing Aaron tries to set the table here, the quarter was 23-4, legitimate enough half mile of 47-3. So Joe's Blazing Aaron on top. King Creesa still second on the outside, imagining up on this good pace, but well held by running along in third. Little Mike is making progress now. He advances up into fourth, passing Nutella back running in fifth. And it's a break of three back to Twilight Eclipse, followed by Slumber. And then Real Solution and Big Blue Kitten still trailing the field as their stablemate leads the way. There's three quarters of a mile left remaining, three quarters up in 1-11-2. Down the backstretch run, Joe's Blazing Aaron, two-length lead. King Creesa has been second throughout here. There's five furlongs to go. Imagining Justin behind the lead, Little Mike racing fourth, about four lengths from the front. And it's a break of another two back to Slumber, who's just on the inside of Twilight Eclipse. Break of another three back to Natello. And now starting to get underway is Real Solution. And Big Blue Kitten is last, but starting to gather momentum now, and he's going to try to make his run through on the rail. So the work is over here for Joe's Blazing Aaron with 3 furlongs remaining. Here comes Little Mike. Little Mike now to seize the lead as they make their way toward the top of the stretch. It is Little Mike now in front. Real Solution coming with a sweeping move on the outside. Twilight Eclipse is also right there. Then imagining Big Blue Kitten is caught in behind the weakening King Creesa. They're coming into the final furlong. It's Little Mike in front. Real Solution bearing down on him from the outside. Slumber's kicking in late. Here comes Slumber with a late run on the outside. Little Mike digging down. Real Solution on the outside. A final try from Big Blue Kitten coming through on the rail. Can Little Mike hold on? Big Blue Kitten comes through on the inside. It's a photo finish. Did Big Blue Kitten just get up in the final strides? Or did Little Mike hold on? It was too close to call here in the Joe Hirsch. Slumber was third. Real Solution was fourth.
But Little Mike, ladies and gentlemen, who hasn't had nearly as good a 2013 as a 2012 for Dale Romans, but Mike Smith scores the nose victory, returning $16.80 for the score in the Joe Hirsch. The entry of Big Blue Kitten and Real Solution, the winners of the Sword Dancer and Arlington Million, finished second and third. 10th race on the card, the $1 million Jockey Club Gold Cup, with about as much anticipation as this race as I've seen in many a year. And when the wagering was finished, flat out the 5-2 choice.
And they're off. And Cross Traffic came walking out of the gate showing no speed whatsoever. Cross Traffic, quite unexpectedly, is dead last. Alpha's the leader, turning into the backstretch run. Alpha's out there by 3. And then Flat Out tugs his way up to be second. Palace Menace on the outside, races third. Ron the Greek is fourth toward the inside, followed by Orb, running fifth, about 4 lengths from the front now, right next to Orb. His last gun for another 4 to Victoria Olympica. And the trailer is a rather sluggish Cross Traffic at this juncture in the race. 5 furlongs from home. The opening quarter for Alpha was 23 4/5 seconds. He's on an uncontested lead. He leads this all-star cast down the backstretch run. Here's a Belmont winner in Palace Malice moving to second. Justin behind Ron the Greek is third after a 47 1/2 mile. Flat Out seeking a hat trick here in the Jockey Club Gold Cup is now fifth, about 5 lengths from the lead. Then Victoria Olympica, Last Gunfighter is in between horses. Orb, the Derby winner's on the outside, is about 8 lengths from the lead. Cross Traffic still well behind as the field moves into the far turn. So it is. Alpha still in control. Palace Malice looms second, a solid 3/4 mark in 1, 10, and 3. The farther back, Ron the Greek is third. Victoria Olympica is now fourth. And Flat Out's on the outside. Flat Out's only 3 lengths from the lead with 3 furlongs remaining here. So it's Alpha. Narrowly as they come to the top of the stretch. Palace Malice is poised to pounce on them as they turn for home now. There's room at the inside for Ron the Greek, and he's coming on through. And Flat Out is full out, but he's still fourth. Victoria Olympica now in fifth. Cross Traffic finally get underway, but they're coming into the final furlong now. And here is Ron the Greek, who's bursting away from the field. Ron the Greek pulling away here, leaving Palace Malice, Victoria Olympica, and all the rest behind. In a huge upset, 21-1. And he ran huge today. Ron the Greek, the winner of the Jockey Club Gold Cup. Palace Malice was second. Flat Out managed third today. It was close there for fourth between Victoria Olympica and Last Gunfighter.
Ron the Greek, Jose Lescano in the saddle, pulls the gigantic upset at 21-1 for Bill Mott. They win off by nearly 7 lengths, returning $44 even. Second choice in the wagering, Palace Malice. Flat Out taste defeat for only the second time at Belmont Park as the 5-2 favorite. Cross Traffic, coming out of the recent good victory in the Whitney at 3-1, beats One Horse. The One Horse at 7-2 and finishing last, Orb. On to Sunday afternoon, 2 juvenile stakes races to bring you. Up first, the 106th running of the Matron Stakes. Sweet Whiskey, even money.
They're in the gate. And they're off. Sweet Whiskey broke like a shot quickly in front of length. Court Dancer has come out running second. On the outside, Misbehavior moves up a spot now. And Art of the Game has come out running in fourth. Gracer's fifth on the outside, six lengths back to Ocean Boulevard. Racing into the far turn, Sweet Whiskey driving on that lead. Misbehavior a length behind in second. Court Dancer third toward the inside. And then it's Gracer who's ranging up now. Gracer on the move from fourth after a snappy opening quarter mile in 22 and 1/5 seconds. Another three to Art of the Game, a long way back to Ocean Boulevard. Here's Misbehavior. Misbehavior ran right by Sweet Whiskey. And Misbehavior opens up, turning for home and doing it willingly, leaving Sweet Whiskey in her wake at the quarter pole. And then Court Dancer. And Gracer's under the whip, well behind the leader at the eighth pole. Misbehavior by four. Sweet Whiskey and Court Dancer, second and third. Misbehavior's starting to weaken. It's late in the game, 100 yards from home. Misbehavior, Sweet Whiskey taking another run at her at the wire. Misbehavior won it by a length at the end. Sweet Whiskey came again, finishing second. Three-way photo for third there among Ocean Boulevard, Gracer, and Court Dancer.
Misbehavior scores the victory as third choice in the wager and returning $8 even. Sweet Whiskey finishes second as the even money favorite, with Gracer finishing third in the matron. Also on the card Sunday afternoon, two-year-olds in the 123rd running of the Futurity Corfu 9-5.
And they're off. In trouble. Here comes Corfu after that lead, and Sound of Freedom's between those two. So up the backstretch, In Trouble and Corfu go head-to-head early on here, 2.5 lengths behind them. Sound of Freedom trying to stay with them, back running in third. And it's Big Sugar Soda, fourth on the outside, three lengths back to Financial Mogul, the trailer. And Corfu dashes away from In Trouble. Corfu opening up here, zipped through a 22-flat opening quarter mile. In Trouble second, Big Sugar Soda third, as Financial Mogul now moves into fourth, and Sound of Freedom is stopping. Coming to the top of the stretch, Corfu still the leader. In Trouble second by another three. Financial Mogul now getting underway and moves to third as the field turns for home. Bigger Sugar Soda back to fourth. Sparkling Half Mile, 44 and 3/5 seconds. Corfu in front, driving on that lead. In Trouble fighting on. In Trouble, Corfu down to the finish. In Trouble's in front. In Trouble to win the Futurity. Battling Corfu most of the way all around, but at the end won it by two, followed by Big Sugar Soda third.
In Trouble, Joe Rocco Jr., Anthony Dutrow, second choice in the wagering, first under the line, returning $7 even. Corfu, a rigid schedule for Juvenile in the Todd Pletcher barn, finishes second with Big Sugar Soda third in the Futurity. That wraps up this week's tremendous edition of Horses and Courses, ladies and gentlemen. Many, many horses now have their work behind them in the Breeders' Cup. Only a few workouts. On Friday afternoon, Keeneland is going to open up. We'll have another big weekend, and then we can get to work on our Breeders' Cup selections. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your stakes action, and join us next time on Horses and Courses.